Hey everybody, it's Dan Harris, host of the Fantasy Pros Football Podcast. Thanks for checking out our video series here at youtube.com/fantasypros. Today we're going to be talking about my top 10 waiver wire pickups for week 8 of the 2020 fantasy football season. All right, at number 10, let's start with Corey Davis. Davis returned from the COVID-19 reserve list to post 6 catches for 35 yards and a touchdown on 10 targets against the Steelers. The 10 targets are probably an anomaly. I mean, the Titans were way behind for most of the game, and they probably won't be in that situation too often. But Davis has played in 4 games, and he's averaging more than 7 targets and 5 catches per game. In an efficient offense like Tennessee's, that is someone who should be able to provide flex value most weeks and should be added in most leagues. At number 9, we're going to the source of all fantasy goodness, and that is with the New York Jets and LaMichael Perine. Frank Gore actually ran pretty well against the Bills, but Perine found the end zone and led the backfield in snaps by a significant margin. Also, Perine ran far more routes, and he saw 3 targets yet again. There's slowly been a changing of the guard in the Jets' backfield, which is simply a product of rational coaching. Perine is probably going to be a borderline flex play against the Chiefs when the Jets will need to go to the air to try unsuccessfully to keep up with Kansas City. But either way, Perine will likely have decent value down the stretch, and he's worth an add. Next up is Trey Burton. Since Burton returned from IR, he hasn't seen fewer than 5 targets in any game, and he started to become an integral part of the Indianapolis offense. Reliable pass catchers are few and far between for the Colts, and we have seen Phillip Rivers rely on his tight ends early and often. Reliable tight ends who you can start every week are a rare commodity. Burton may just fit the bill, and he's a worthy pickup. Next up is Jalen Reagor. Reagor has been designated for return from injured reserve, and he can now practice with the Eagles. It seems unlikely that he's going to be able to play this weekend, and the Eagles are on a bye in week 9, so Reagor is more of a long-term move for your fantasy team. But there's a ton of potential for the rookie wide receiver, particularly with DeSean Jackson out for much, if not all, of the remainder of the season. Add Reagor now, rather than waiting for after the Eagles' bye week. At number 6, it's Jamichael Hasty. With Jeff Wilson and Raheem Mostert on IR, and Tevin Coleman uncertain for week 8, Hasty becomes someone that RB needy fantasy teams need to add immediately. There are caveats, of course. Hasty was a complete afterthought until this past week, and there's a matchup with Seattle on tap, which is a bad one for running backs. Most of all, this is Kyle Shanahan's team. Other than with Mostert, and for a brief time last year with Tevin Coleman, Shanahan has been impossible to predict with running backs. Given the landscape, Hasty is probably going to rank as a flex this coming week, if not a dicey one, but that's still worth an add. At number 5, let's talk about another San Francisco running back, and that's Tevin Coleman. You just heard me say that Coleman is uncertain for this week, and that Kyle Shanahan messes with his running backs. But once upon a time, Tevin Coleman was a reliable source of 13 plus touches and a trusted option for Shanahan for a few games. Remember, Jerick McKinnon was, quote, rested despite not playing much lately, and Hasty is an undrafted free agent who hadn't made any noise at all until recently. A healthy Coleman is going to get work, so long as Raheem Mostert is out, and we know that's at least a couple of more weeks, if not more. If you have an immediate need, Coleman might not be the perfect fit, but he's certainly an add in this environment regardless. Next up, it's Rashard Higgins. Higgins caught all 6 of his targets for 110 yards against the Bengals, and his bigger workload was the result of Odell Beckham Jr. leaving the game with an injury. And now, Beckham's out for the season, and Higgins moves into a major role as the second wide receiver for the Browns behind Jarvis Landry. Now, Baker Mayfield is not going to throw 5 touchdown passes every week like he did on Sunday, but still, Beckham was seeing a pretty reliable 7 targets per week. Those vacated targets have to go somewhere. Higgins can be started this week and for the rest of the season. At number 3, it's Sterling Shepard. Shepard returned and right out of the gate saw 8 targets, hauling in 6 of them for 59 yards and a score against the Eagles. 8 targets, 6 catches, 59 yards. What did Shepard average last year? 8 targets, 6 catches, 58 yards per game. Now those numbers don't blow you away unless you're accompanied by a touchdown, but they're pretty reliable in this day and age. In a season where reliability is probably the single most important attribute for any player, Shepard should be added immediately. At number 2, it's Brandon Ayuk. Deebo Samuel has already been declared out for this week's game against the Seahawks, and that opens the door wide for Ayuk. The talented rookie caught 6 of his 7 targets for 115 yards against the Patriots, and he has the perfect skill set for this 49ers offense. But really, look, the 49ers are now down their top 2 running backs and their best receiver, and they're going to need offense against the Seahawks. That means plenty of work for Ayuk, who should threaten wide receiver 2 status this week and into the future, with Samuel likely to miss at least 2 games. And your number one pickup this week is Carlos Hyde. Hyde is dealing with some hamstring tightness, but it's almost a certainty that Chris Carson is going to miss this weekend's game with a foot sprain. Travis Homer also hurt his knee on Sunday, meaning the door is wide open for Hyde, particularly considering how effective he was on Sunday night. He's not a particularly special running back, but someone in an elite offense who is guaranteed 15 to 20 touches is a must-start option. For this week, and maybe going forward for a few more, Hyde's going to be in every fantasy lineup, and he should be the top ad of Week 8. And that's going to do it for my top 10 waiver wire pickups for Week 8 of the 2020 fantasy football season. As always, thanks for checking out our video series here at youtube.com/fantasypros. Don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, and Facebook @fantasypros so you don't miss all of the great content that we're going to be putting out for the rest of the season.